Hello everyone and welcome or welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to talk about fertilisers, and this is going to be a bit of a guide for beginners and those who are new to the hobby, because fertilisers can feel like one of the most confusing parts of a planted aquarium. Which ones do you really need? How much do you actually dose? And do you even need them at all? So in this video, I'm going to break it down as simply as I can so that you'll know exactly what to use, why it matters, and how to keep your aquarium plants healthy without overcomplicating things. I also need to apologize because I'm full of cold and I sound husky or manly, or maybe like Barry White. So I apologize for my voice. My brain's also not working fantastic, so I have notes to the side. So if you're wondering why I keep glazing out away from the camera, it's because I forgot what I'm talking about. So anyway, without any further ado, let's jump into it. So plants and aquariums rely on nutrients in the water and the substrate to grow. But unlike nature, the nutrients in your tank don't renew themselves, and fish waste and leftover food can provide some nutrients, but it's not often enough for strong growth. So without fertilizers, you may notice a few things like yellowing leaves or pinholes or stunted growth. And basically, fertilizers just replace the missing nutrients that plants would more likely get in nature. And this obviously helps your aquarium plants to stay green and strong and vibrant looking. So I would say there are like two main types of fertilizer. So you have root fertilizers or root tabs or root capsules. They go by a lot of different names, but we'll go with root tabs. And they go directly in the substrate. And these slowly release nutrients right to where heavy root feeders like crips or echinodorus or lotuses, right where they need them. And these are specifically great for heavy root feeders. And then you've got liquid fertilizer, which you probably more commonly see, and this is what you dose directly into the water column. And this will feed things like stem plants, floating plants, epiphytes, anubias, bucephalandra, java fern, plants that like to take nutrients up through their leaves. Of course, all plants like to, but some tend to focus more on getting it through their roots, and some will both happily take it through leaves and roots. So a combination of both root tabs and liquid fertilizer kind of gives you a good basis to tackle every single plant that you could have in your aquarium. So a lot of beginners wonder whether or not to use an all-in-one fertilizer or to dose individual nutrients. And basically, an all-in-one fertilizer is perfect for most people. It includes both macros like nitrogen, potassium, and phosphate, and it includes micros like iron, manganese, and everything else in between. So basically your trace elements. And it's a simple and convenient way to do it, and it works for almost every aquascaper and pretty much every plant that you would use in a low-tech or beginner or medium-tech tank. Whereas individual dosing, it gives you a little bit more control, and it's useful if your plants are showing specific signs of deficiencies. So, for example, a nitrogen deficiency may often show as older leaves turning pale or yellow, and you might have some funny looking growth, or it might be a bit stunted. Whereas an iron deficiency usually appears with pale new growth or fading red colours in red plants like Ludwigias and Rotalas. A magnesium deficiency can show again as yellowing between the veins of older leaves. A calcium deficiency can lead to twisted or deformed leaves, whereas a potassium deficiency is usually the easiest one to spot because it leaves pinholes in the leaves. But keep in mind that deficiencies can present quite differently depending upon the plant species, and in general, just yellowing, stunted, or abnormal growth, which can happen with any plant with any nutrient deficiency. But if you see that, it is just usually a good indicator that something is missing, and you should probably start with the macros, so usually nitrogen or potassium. So the takeaway from that is kind of simple, and that is just use an all-in-one fertilizer and only move to individual dosing if you notice specific nutrient problems, and that way you are addressing the actual issue instead of just second guessing. So one that a lot of people can often overlook is water hardness, and your water hardness also plays a role in how plants respond to fertilizers. And in most areas with medium or hard tap water, your water basically already contains plenty of calcium and magnesium. So you don't usually need to worry. But if you are in a very, very soft water area, generally with a TDS of say 100 or less, your plants might be missing some essential nutrients. So calcium is especially important for building things like strong cell walls, so the leaves and the stems don't grow twisted or deformed. And magnesium is sort of a core element in the chlorophyll, which plants need for photosynthesis. So if it's missing, older leaves may turn yellow. And as mentioned earlier, it kind of gets the yellowing in between the veins, where the leaf itself will stay kind of green looking. So in these cases, you could maybe consider adding a GH booster or something like Sea Chem Equilibrium, I believe, which can add the minerals back into the water, and it can make a big difference. And once that's covered, you could maybe consider also adding a trace mix like Sea Chem Trace, which adds smaller elements like iron, magnesium, zinc, to just improve colour and overall plant health. But of course, there is lots of other brands. I'm not sponsored by Sea Chem. I'm just saying Sea Chem because that's what I personally use. So if you are just starting out, if you are completely new to the hobby, or you're just a little bit lost and you're not sure what you should be doing, this is what I would recommend keeping on hand at all times, so you've got all bases covered. So I would firstly keep a reliable all-in-one fertilizer that covers both macros and micros, which is obviously suitable for all plants. I wouldn't say that I recommend any brand in particular. I think all big brands on the market are pretty good. So just whatever you can get and whatever you can afford is always going to be better than nothing. And then I would say get yourself some root tabs, and these are for the heavy feeders like crips, swords, lilies, and yeah, any other sort of heavy root feeding plants, but I'd say they're sort of like the big three. And that's it. And I would say that this combination is enough to see strong growth in almost every beginner tank, and even later on down the line. And finally, how much should you be dosing? Dusty chicken. Where were we? How much should you be dosing? Well, I always recommend people to start small and adjust based on your plants. So generally, I underdose based on what the bottle says, and that is because the bottle or the manufacturer has probably tested this on, well, I don't know, what have they tested it on? That's the thing. If you don't have a lot of plants and they've tested that on a very heavily planted tank, then you are very much overdosing. So I would always say go half of what the manufacturer says on the bottle and work up from there, because it's so much easier to deal with problems where you've underdosed nutrients rather than overdosed, which would probably result in a massive algae bloom, or potentially a massive algae bloom. So yeah, start small and adjust based on your plants. Things like yellowing and pinholes in leaves usually means that they need more of a certain nutrient, and it's usually a macronutrient, as we mentioned, nitrogen or potassium. But just pay attention to your plants, they'll tell you what they need. And remember, fertilizers alone don't cause algae. It's a balance between light, nutrients, and CO2. But obviously, if you do get algae when you start dosing, it could just be an indicator that you are using too much fertilizer. Alongside with how much should you dose is also when should you dose and how often should you dose. And again, the manufacturer might recommend dosing daily, they might recommend dosing every couple of days. My advice again would be to ignore the manufacturer. No, but I dose, me personally, once after a water change and once again midweek. And again, if the plants don't look healthy, I will add a little bit more and adjust as needed. I don't fertilize the tank in the first few weeks of setting up, especially if I've used an aqua soil, because your aqua soil is giving the plants lots of nutrients that way. So yeah, basically once or twice a week. And that's even if I remember. And that is with an all-in-one fertilizer. The only exception to the rule is on my high-tech 90 centimeter aquarium, because there are a lot of hungry plants in there. I dose in all-in-one, but I also add additional nitrogen and potassium because I feel like the all-in-one doesn't quite give it just enough. Whereas these tanks here, which to be honest, rarely ever get dosed. This tank is coming up 3 years old now. I've never put a root tab in it. and I use a basic all-in-one fertilizer after a water change once a week, and that's all it gets. And is it the most perfect tank in the world? No, absolutely not. But it's trouble-free. It looks nice to me and everything's quite happy in it. What do you think, chicken? Not impressed. So I think what the point is that we're trying to say is always start less and build up, because it just gives you a lot more control that way, and it's a lot easier to deal with issues that way. So to sum up, root tabs for root feeders, liquid fertilizer for everything else. All-in-ones are perfect for beginners. Pay attention to your water hardness. If the water is very soft, a GH booster can help, along with additional trace elements to support color and overall health. Dose a little, watch your plants, and adjust as needed. Fertilizers definitely do not need to be complicated, and with just a couple of products that don't break the bank, you can get amazing results with your tank. And if this guide helped you, please hit subscribe for more planted tank tips, and let me know in the comments, what fertilizer are you currently using and how's it working out for your plants? It might just help somebody. Thank you so much for watching. Thanks for putting up with my horrible voice today. Thanks for putting up with this naughty little chicken, and we will see you on the next one. Chicken, what? Do you have anything to say? Do you have a comment to make about the poos on the floor? It wasn't you.
What?
A pigeon broke in and did it. When? I'm shocked too. I cannot believe that. It doesn't sound real. Wow. And then he framed you. You are innocent.